11月21日至23日，温哥华另类时装周。这个为期3天的温哥华另类时装周于11月21日至23日在 The Maritime Labor Center 举行，挑选出超过50位艺术家、音乐家、表演者和设计者，展示他们无与伦比的创造力和艺术创作。今年的 World 包括可穿戴艺术、音乐、素描、油画、混合媒体作品，同时还有雕塑、电影、表演艺术、摄影以及互动装置等。
大家好，我们现在是在2014年温哥华特别时尚周末，在我的左边是两个 co-founder。Hello。
Hi there.
Welcome. And your names are?
I'm Kat Furnio. I'm the creative director.
And I'm Kat Kozak. I'm the media director.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for joining us, ladies. So tell me.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about your alternative Vancouver Fashion Weekend.
Well, one thing that we do that's very different from many other fashion weeks is we have, you know, live performances of music. We have live visual artists who do performance art pieces. We have an exhibition of artwork.We have all sorts of amazing additional elements that relate to ideals of beauty outside of clothing, which is pretty amazing.
Great. And has there been a lot of coverage?
Yes, actually, for the third year that we're just entering this year, we've had over 30 media passes given out over the course of the weekend, which is awesome, as well as numerous people come here with their cameras and iPhones and all the things and like to take tons of pictures of the event, as well as we have a great team of videographers on site, too, that make a fantastic film at the end of the weekend.
Wonderful. This really feels quite unique from the costume to the hair to all the beautiful art. Is there a theme?
Yes, this year our theme is vicissitudes. What we always do every year is we have one overarching theme and then 3 broken up themes for each evening of the event. And this year vicissitudes actually means a change or diametric change from one thing to its exact opposite. So we've had Revolution Night was our launch night. Then we had Evolution last night, and this is our final night, which is Revelation.
Wow. Are there going to be some fireworks or a big finish?
There's definitely going to be a big finish, but I can't really break anything now.
Oh, okay. I hear you guys have a variety of different types of models involved. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, absolutely. We feel at Vault that there are many different concepts of beauty, and narrowing everything down into a singular body type or visual look of a model is sort of nonsensical. We want everyone in our audience to see themselves on the runway in the models that we select. So they come in a range of ages, sizes, gender situations, levels of body modification, unusual hair colors, the whole shebang. So we like to have a real good variety. It does make it a lot more complicated, but it's very worthwhile.
Wonderful. And when you say alternative, does that mean like punk and steampunk and like mythical, Middle Earth, like the way you're dressed? Like, what does it mean?
To us, alternative is taking fashion outside of industry and treating it as an art form. So it's less about, you know, following the traditional cycles of trends and seasons and, you know, functionality in some cases, and just turning into a full art form where each piece is generally one of a kind, which really makes for an interesting show.
And what kind of impact has it had on the fashion designers and artists that are involved?
We feel that it's been very, very positive for many of those designers. We've had some incredibly positive responses, and in fact, the vast majority of our designers come back year after year. So we've still retained several designers from year one, which I think is a testament to how well we take care of them.
So is this a celebration of artistry and beauty, or is this really a showcase in terms of entrepreneurship and bringing them to a bigger stage?
I would say all of the above. I mean, you know, all these people are doing this on the side or maybe as their full-time business, and this is an opportunity for them to showcase themselves to maybe another community that they haven't already considered or been a part of. So I mean, it's both entrepreneur and artistic form of expression.
Wonderful. And seeing that there's so many different types of artists, are there commonalities between them?
Absolutely. Really, art comes down to nothing to do with what medium you're in. It's really just about having something that you have to create. And I feel that having having an event like this where it all comes together, you end up having all of these attendees who are willing to, you know, go that extra mile to get that one unique piece and wear it for 10 years rather than, you know, buy a t-shirt, throw it out by the next season and get a new item. So this is definitely bringing, you know, the right audience to the right creators, which I think is a really amazing thing to do.
So what has inspired you ladies to come together and put on this fabulous show?
Well, honestly, she wants me to answer. We have been thinking about this for a long time, but I used to be a fashion designer. I was creating work for several years, and I was always showing at Toronto Alternative Fashion Weekend. And Kat Kozak here was always photographing my work. And we were always a really great team when it came to that. And we loved the show. It was so eclectic, and it was so wild, and it still is. but we decided to move out here, and BC really called to us. We love Vancouver. It's an amazing city that's really unique. And it seemed like it made the most sense for something like an alternative fashion week to exist here, and we were shocked to find that it didn't. So we felt that it was our turn to give back and
so
make it happen.
There was a gap in the marketplace.
Exactly. There are lots of fashion weeks here, but we all cater to very different niche markets.
I see. Well, wonderful. Congratulations on all the success, and we look forward to a wonderful evening. Thank you, ladies.
Well, thanks for coming.
I hope you enjoyed the show.
Come see us at Vault 2015.
Awesome. And is there a website where people can find you?
Absolutely. It's www.vault.ca. Remember, it's spelled V-A-L-T. No U.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
That fly by behind our eyes. This tumbling torrent is the template we draw form from. Daily life rises, dripping out of this rushing mythic river. Our dreams gestate, take shape within the waters of this place, but like fish born swimming, we do not know how the river wets our dreams. We just drink it in with eternal thirst, always thirsty for stories, things, images, thirsty for the mythos that drives our unbidden rhythms. Need a metaphor, like nourishment to feed our inner worlds, and we grasp at myth offered, like a babe on her mama's breast.
感谢收看今天的大温故事，我们下期再见。